Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of band president Mr. Gary Mason and all the members of the Pawleys Island Concert Band, welcome to our 15th annual celebration of Christmas and music. Our conductors this evening are Mr. Carson Turner and Charles Mayhew, and Dr. Lana Stevens Pawley with the Pawleys Island Presbyterian Church Choir. We are truly honored to bring you this small bit of musical holiday spirit tonight. Please take a moment to silence your electronic devices, and if you find that you need to leave the auditorium during the performance, please try to do so between selections if you can. And now, please stand, if you are able, for the National Anthem of the United States of America, Star Spangled Banner.
One of the most important parts of a concert band like we have here is audience. Because if we don't have an audience, we're just having a band rehearsal, you know what I'm saying? So I really think, and I see lots of familiar faces here year after year, our friends Betty McKinney, and lots of faces out here that I don't know but recognize. And I'd like for the band to give you a hand. Thank you very much. One of the hard things to do to keep a volunteer organization together, especially if there are no paid employees or members of the organization. But for 15 years, this band has been playing. Isn't that remarkable? Lots of people to thank in the band, but I want to thank, first of all, we wouldn't be a band if we didn't have a place to rehearse, and the Merle's Inlet Presbyterian Church furnishes us not only a band room, but a place to keep all of my junk, which includes these drums here, and you know, all the stuff here has to be stored there, and they are so gracious. So would you give the Merle's Inlet Presbyterian Church a hand? I'm curious myself. I would ask those members of this band that have been here from the beginning, 15 years, if you'll stand up and let's see if we can recognize how many of us there are. Maxie, Bob, I'm a 15-year-old. Thank you. Bonnie and Bob had the brainchild to start a community band 15 years ago and did an excellent job of getting it started, and they left and came back. Love the band, so we're glad to have them. And Betty, did you get a list of all the charter members? I ask it to you. We have a board that takes care of the business part of the band. We get a little grant from the state of South Carolina every year, and our board members take care of the money part. And I want to ask the board members to stand. Carson's up on the board. He's leaning. Chuck Mayhew, other conductor. Lynn Versalotti, our treasurer. Lynn keeps us in the black, and he's done a great job of getting that great grant every year. Peggy Welch, our secretary. At large, Craig Casey. No offense, Craig. Mike Wallace, assistant treasurer. Dwayne Graham, I call him our sergeant at arms because takes care, keeps people in line. And I'm Gary Mason, and I play timpani. Thank you very much. It's time to beg for money. We need money. Not a lot, but if you have any loose change, we have a box out there. That keeps the band going. We buy music, we buy a few instruments. If you can donate to the band, we're a 501c3, I believe it is, and it's a tax-deductible donation. Something I just learned recently this year is when you get to be a geezer, you have to take minimum distributions on your IRA, you know what I'm saying? You have to take 3.7% every year. Well, if you don't want to pay tax on that, you can send that directly to the Pawleys Island Concert Band. avoid all taxation, so I encourage you to do that. Finally, for his outstanding service, vision, and dedication to the Pawleys Island Concert Band, without you and your family and their continued support and commitment, and the family really is vital to our band. This is 100% what they do. They do a fantastic job. We would not be a community band we are without you. We present this award to Carson Turner, Music Director and Principal Conductor, Pawleys Island Concert Band, December 18, 2018.
Thank you all so much. So I try my best to not make it about me, and Gary does stuff like that, because it's not about me. If all I did was stand up here and flap my arms, and there were no musicians to play any music, I'd be doing aerobics. While that would be good for me and my heart doctor would like it, it wouldn't be near as fun. So this is really about the band. This is the band's band. And each concert, I like to take a minute and recognize one of the people who do the things, and any of you who've ever been in an organization, you know, that there are things that get done that nobody ever thinks about. And they just get done. And everybody comes to the bowling league, and there's a tournament. And nobody thinks about, well, you know, who mopped the floor? So each season, I like to recognize somebody, and this season, she's going to be really surprised because she hates this kind of thing as much as I do. We have prepared 4 different shows since August. I don't know if the band realizes the magnitude of what we have accomplished. 4 full shows since August. We've done 12 performances since August. One of them was at Walt Disney World. We went to Walt Disney World, and we played on the main stage. We did the Wynja Auditorium show with Bill Wilbers that was just marvelous. If you didn't get to go, you would still want to go. We do all of that playing music in these folders. About 10 or 12 pieces of music per show. And if you count that up, that's about 50 pieces of music this season since August in 50 people's folders. We have a library that is the single most valuable asset of this band. It's in the tens of thousands of dollars worth of music. And we have a librarian who makes all of that happen. She doesn't play anything. In fact, she knows very little about music. But she's always there. And she's quick to look at somebody and say, well, you better find the third page to Holiday Festival. Do I look like I have a copier in my pocket? But then somehow, miraculously, she produces us a third page to Holiday Festival, and we go on. And without Betty, where Betty's up there. More hours than I do, and after we're all done taking a break until January, she's got to take all this music in and sort it out and put it in order and put it back in its boxes so that next year when we want to do Sleigh Ride for the 14th of 15 years, we'll be able to play it. And so for you, we went and got you in my bag a cookie. And, as I know how my Betty is, a little stuffed reindeer. Oh, look at that. Yeah, see? See, I got lucky with my wife. Y'all have to go buy jewelry.
All right, on with the show.
So, Betty, you rock.